Hi, and welcome to the Assembly Lines podcast. I'm Chris Torrance. In today's episode, I'm excited to talk about two new video products for the Apple II. So let's get started. There are a lot of different options out there for cards that can convert your Apple II output to something that a modern monitor can handle, either HDMI or VGA. And I thought it might be fun to just go through the ones that I currently have and then talk about the two new ones. So starting here in the upper left, we've got the VidHD card from John Brooks. This came out several years ago and it does DVI output from pretty much any Apple II with slots. It has a lot of different modes that the Apple II can't normally output. For example, things like 132 column text and just different color backgrounds. There are a few disadvantages. These cards are pretty much unobtainium nowadays. It was also pretty expensive at the time, and it had a nasty habit of eating floppy disks if you booted your Apple II with a floppy disk in the drive at the same time. Moving on, we have the A2N2O, or the A2FPGA card, and this is one that I just reviewed a few weeks ago. This is an FPGA solution which combines the HDMI output along with mocking board support as well as the Super Sprite card. This is a really cool card if you have an Apple II with slots as well. Finally, we have the Apple II VGA card. This particular version happens to be from Vince Briel, but there's a lot of different flavors out there. This one only does VGA output, but it's inexpensive and you could solder this one together yourself. Moving over here, we have the Apple IIc Night Owl monitor, and this one has just been fitted with a special plug that plugs into the Apple IIc video out and just brings out the composite as well as the power, so you don't need to have a separate power supply for this monitor. Finally, we come to the two new cards, and these are the ones that I want to talk about today. On the left here, we have the A2 DVI card, and this provides both HDMI as well as VGA output for any Apple II with a slot, except for the Apple II GS. And then over here, we have the Tangy board, which is from Rob Kim, and this is actually a custom solution only for the Apple IIc, and again, it plugs into the Apple IIc's video port. So let's take a look at these two cards more closely and try them out. Here we have the two new solutions for VGA and HDMI output for your Apple II. On the left, we have the A2 DVI. This is a new card by Raul Palaviv and Torsten Brem. Raul actually did the hardware design for it based on some earlier card designs, and Torsten has done the HDMI firmware. You can see from this card that it actually has both HDMI and VGA. There's actually another version of this card that only does HDMI, which is a little bit cheaper. I'll have links to where you can purchase all of these cards in the show notes. The firmware for the A2 DVI card actually came out of several different projects. There was a Pico DVI project by Luke Wren, and so Torsten took that and extended it to this card to provide the HDMI output. And then the VGA firmware is based on projects by Mark Akins and David Cooter. The unique advantages of this card is it'll work in pretty much any Apple II with slots except for the 2GS. It currently supports all of the Apple II and IIe video modes in both color and monochrome. And so this is including 40 or 80 column text, low res, double low res, high res, and double high res. And it has an on-screen menu for configuration, and we'll see that in a few minutes. Moving over here, this is the Tangy Pack by Rob Kim. Rob actually demoed this card at Kansas Fest 2023, and he made some significant improvements over the past year, and this is the new version of the card that he was selling at Kansas Fest 2024. I've actually taken the cover off, so you can just see what it looks like inside, but it actually comes with this attractive cover which completely hides the electronics and shields it. But you can see for this card, he's actually using a Tang Nano FPGA to do all the heavy lifting. And this provides the HDMI output on the left And then he also has VGA output over on the right-hand side. This card plugs into the back of the Apple IIc into the video port. And the video port provides both the composite signal as well as power for the board. So let's go ahead and try both of these cards out and see how they work. Let's take a look at Rob Kim's Tangy Pack first, since that's the most straightforward. Here you can see I've plugged in my HDMI cable into the port on the side, and then I'm just going to plug the adapter into the back in the Apple IIc's video port. A couple things to keep in mind. You have to have the handle on the Apple IIc down so that the case can actually fit on properly like that into the little recess. And then Rob strongly recommends that you screw down the terminal screw nuts here, because you're not supposed to remove the Tangy Pack when the Apple IIc has power, and it might be possible, if you don't screw it down, to jostle it and knock this out. So now that I've got that plugged in, we should be good to go. And I'm just going to turn on the Apple IIc and we'll see what the video looks like. You'll notice that I'm using Javier Rivera's new Apple IIc USB power adapter here. And this is really nice. It shows me the voltage that's currently being supplied to the Apple IIc. And then it just has a port here where I can plug in just a regular USB-C power supply. I'm gonna go ahead and turn on the Apple IIc. It looks like the HDMI adapter is working. It's come up with the Apple IIc. It's currently booting Nox Archaist, so we'll be able to see the double high-res splash screen and see what that looks like. Nox Archaist. You can see that double high res looks really good. The colors appear to be correct. I can use the buttons here on the top of the Tangy Pack to switch, say, from regular scan line mode to non-scan lines. And then I can use the middle button here to change from color mode to green mode, orange, and then, or amber, and then white, and then back to color mode. And then finally, I can change the background color of the screen by hitting the button on the right. So there's white, blue, green, and then back to black. Let's go ahead now and we'll boot up the rest of the game and see what that looks like. All right, so there's the game itself. The colors look crisp and sharp. If anything, I might say that they look a little bit too crisp, and this is sometimes a drawback of doing HDMI output on an Apple II, is you need to actually emulate a little bit of color blurring like there might be on an old CRT, and maybe this is something that Rob can do in a firmware update. But other than that, the colors look really good. Let's go ahead and we'll take a look at 40 column and 80 column and see what that looks like. This is 40 column mode right here, and you can see it looks nice and sharp. Let's switch to 80 column mode here and see what that looks like. Okay, so here's our cursor here, and then let's just type like a simple program. And we'll just run that. All right, so 80 column text appears very crisp, easily readable. There's no color fringing or anything. So that looks really good. Let's go ahead and try the game Undead, which just came out from 8-bit Shack. This is a really good test of double low resolution. All right, that looks fantastic. Looks pretty much just the same as it did on the A2 FPGA card that I did a review on a couple weeks ago. Okay, let's switch gears and we'll take a look at the A2 DVI card. We'll go ahead and fire up Nox Archaist just like we did on the Apple IIc to see what the double high res looks like. And you can see that pretty much looks just as good as the Tangy Pack. The colors are crisp and sharp. Here, I don't have scan lines turned on. I could have enabled that in the menu, but I didn't. But this looks fantastic. Let's see what the game looks like. This actually looks fantastic. I would say this looks as good or better than the A2F PGA that I reviewed a few weeks ago. This also looks just as good as the VidHD card. Let's take a look at the configuration modes for the A2 DVI. It comes with a floppy disk image called A2 DVI config. One thing I'm not gonna have time to get into today is the A2 DVI actually lets you upload your own custom font set to use with the Apple II. And so this could just be like either a fun font or something with perhaps some custom characters for your language. But let's go ahead and we'll just open up the configuration menu. So I've put the A2 DVI in slot 3. And so here we can see all the different options. The machine type, by default, it's set to auto detect, but we can also force it to Apple II, IIe, Eggate 7, 9, Abasis, Pravitz, etc. And we'll just leave it at auto detect. The character set is what we want to use, and these are all built in. And you can see some of the characters down here at the bottom. This is in addition to the ones that you might upload yourself. So we'll just go back to US. The enhanced font is whether you want to use mouse text characters like in the Apple IIe enhanced, or whether you want to use these standard characters that came with just the unenhanced IIe. So that's kind of nice. The card itself has a pinout. If you have a Euro Apple, then you can actually plug the language switch on your actual Euro Apple into the back of the card. That will allow the card to honor the language switch on the Euro Apple itself. Here is the character set that you're going to use. And so we have various options for that. 2E US, US Reactive, Unenhanced, 2+. So we'll just go back to the regular. Here's monochrome mode. So whether you want black and white, green, amber, color mode, so you can either do color or monochrome. Scan lines, do you want those on or off? Analog render effects. So this is what I was talking about earlier with Rob Kim's card. If you turn that off, then it'll make everything as crisp as possible, but you won't get any of that kind of bleeding or blending like you might have with a old school CRT. So we probably want to leave that enabled. The Video 7 mode is actually for the Lachette Mauve Video 7 Apple Color RGB card. And so I don't hardly even know what that is. So we'll just leave that enabled, I guess. Debug monitor is kind of nice. That'll actually, if you enable that, it'll actually tell you some information while the Apple II is running. And so you can see it actually puts these up above the top of the screen and down below. So these won't actually interfere with whatever you're doing. It even tells you the 6502 program counter, where it currently is, the stack pointer, and then what zero page location was just written. So that's pretty nifty. So if I make any changes in here, it will only take effect for this session. And if I reboot the computer, it will have forgotten it all. However, I can actually tell it to save to flash memory or load from flash memory. And if I do that, then it'll actually save these values for the next time that I fire up the computer. So I don't think I've actually changed anything. We'll just kind of leave everything alone. And let's go ahead and we'll fire up some games. Okay, again, we've fired up Undead by Dan Henderson and Mark Golombek. They just finished their Kickstarter, and I'll put a link in the show notes for where you can get more information. Okay, so this is double low resolution, and you can see this looks fantastic. The colors are incredibly crisp and clear. They look really good. Okay, so that is double low res. Finally, let's do the same thing we did with the Tangy Pack and take a look at 40 and 80 column text. Okay, so here is 40 column text, and that looks good. There's no color fringing, everything's crisp. Let's switch to 80 columns now to appear number 3, and then we will list our program, and now we'll just run it. And 80 column looks fantastic, just as good as the Tangy Pack, completely readable. You could certainly do any sort of 80 column work you needed to on this card. Overall impressions of these two cards, they're both amazing. It's really nice that we have a good HDMI solution for the Apple IIc. That platform tends to not get as much love as the other Apple II platforms. So it's nice that Rob Kim has created such an awesome card for it. I really like the form factor. I like the 3D printed case. It's a little unclear whether Rob's going to have these generally available for sale. I think it's something that if you reach out to him, he'll make one for you. The price, at least when I bought one, was very reasonable. I like that it has both HDMI and VGA output. People tend to have a lot of monitors lying around that use either VGA or HDMI, so it's nice to have the option. The color bleeding on the Tangy Pack seemed to be a little bit more than what I was used to, especially for trying to read text in something like Nox or Caist. So maybe that's something that Rob could take a look at and see if he can make some firmware updates to make that look a little bit crisper. As far as the A2 DVI, this is the card for the Apple II, II Plus, or IIe. The graphics looked amazing on this. I did notice the first time that I booted up that Undead game that there were a few glitches or artifacts in the lines on the screen that would kind of, every now and then you'd just see like a black line jump across the screen. When I switched that analog mode to change the colors, then that behavior seemed to go away. But maybe this is something that they can take a look at and see if there's something that needs to be tweaked in their firmware. Again, the price is very reasonable. There's a couple different versions. The one with both HDMI and VGA, I think, was something like 55 euros. And then the one with only the HDMI was something like 45 euros. So that's a really good price for what you're getting. The colors were amazing with that card. I'm really impressed. It'd be really nice if that configuration utility was somehow available directly from within the Apple II, perhaps through an on-screen menu without having to boot a separate disk. I don't know whether that's something that could be possible in a future update. I'll have links in the show notes for where you can get more information for both of these cards. Also, if you haven't subscribed to my YouTube channel, I'd really appreciate it if you'd hit the subscribe button below. I also have a Patreon if you'd like to support me that way, and I'll have a link in the show notes to that. Once again, thanks for watching.